What you are looking at right now is not Airtable. It's a brand new Softr database, not just a connector, but a fully standalone database built into Softr. In this video, I'll show you how it works, explore whether it can truly replace Airtable, and push it to the limit to see just how many records it can handle. Stick around. Hi, this is Greg from Business Automated. We got asked by the Softr team to review their latest product, still in beta, which is Softr databases. As I mentioned, this is not a connector. This is completely standalone database, which you can actually even find in a different place inside of their UI. So you will see that over here you have the data sources where you can connect one of those many connectors, but you can also create here separately your brand new database. You can see at the first glance that this layout looks fairly similar to Airtable. We have ability to have multiple tables, we have ability to import the data from different sources, we have views, we have filters, sorts, fields, we don't have ability to group, we don't have ability to share, but again, we're going to be building something that is shareable on top of it, so probably that's not relevant. Let's look a bit more at the fields that are available. So you can see that those fields look fairly similar in terms of single select or even linked fields. So the same powerful ability to link to different records exists also here. Let's try to create new fields so that you can see what are our choices. So you can see that a bit of a difference is that you have the relationship fields separated. So you know that all of them are related to other records over here. And you can also see that metadata type of records, so created by, are also separated over here. What I really like is that there's a dedicated record ID field. So the same way as in Airtable, we even don't need to name those records when we create a new one. We also have a formula field, and I have tested the formula field. And from what I can see, it does work on the same basis as Airtable formula, so you can use the same Airtable formulas. At the moment, what is missing is the syntax highlighting. From that perspective, you can see that it works the same. We can also create a new field here, and we can, for example, import data from a CSV file. So we'll try with our sample here. We are importing here a small sample of data that represents a social media post performance on different channels. So you can see the views, shares, and so on. So I have just dropped a CSV file over here and I started the import. And now you can see that this got automatically imported over here and we automatically got tags. We also got tags for the titles, which is fine. We also have the date field and we have successfully recognized the number. So that looks pretty good. This was not too big of a sample. It's about 1,200 records. Now the question, how would you use it inside of Softr? So if we go to the Softr, this is the familiar Softr UI that you can see from my other videos. Normally when you put a data block, then the first step when you add, for example, a list would be to select a data source. So this is exactly the same thing. You'll see that Softr databases show up together with all the other data connections that you would have. And exactly the same way, you can pick one of the databases that you have and then pick a table. So really nothing changes. You will notice then all those fields will also show up over here in the item field selection and you can add them exactly the same way. So for example, we can add status over here and for example, inside of status, we can change the colors to be the same as defined in the data source. You will see that the colors from the data source carry over. So this is the same setup as you would have in Airtable. So let's use our newly imported data to create a chart out of it. We'll add a line chart and we'll select our social media results. And now we will summarize it using the views and group them by date. And you can see that this is fairly neat. 1,200 records that are displayed over here. We can also add subgrouping and we'll subgroup them by specific channel. So you can see that we have four different channels, which are more or less the same in terms of numbers, but we do have a separate line for each one of them. And here you can see separate parameters for each one of them, that's social channels. Looking at this chart, it seems that Softr handled the data pretty well and was able to summarize these records with no problem. This is only 1,200 records. So my thought was, how many more records can we push into this database? And knowing the pricing for Airtable, this is a sort of the key differentiator between different plans. So you get 50,000 records on the lowest plan, and then 100 plus on the business plans, and 500 on the enterprise scale. Let's see how many records can we add to Softr database. So let me start importing another file. So I'll import from CSV, and it's importing the data. And I have prepared over here files that contain the same mock data, social media posts. The initial file was only 30 days. The file that I have uploaded now is slightly bigger. It's 360 days, and that is about 18,000 records. So let's see how Softr handled that. The file got uploaded. I paused the video for a second, so it took longer than what you see. But as you can see, we have 18,000 records with no issue. Like, we have all those records showing up fairly quickly. You know, like, they're still loading, but as much as I'm jumping, they're still. Let's do another thing. So let's add another file, import data. And I dropped here in the next file, which contains 75,000 records. And you can see that's already 7 megabytes. So this is getting significantly bigger, and it's still being imported. In the meantime, let's see how the chart would be handling the bigger number of records. So let's update the chart over here. And this one is being right now imported. This one will be 18,000 records. And let's do a preview, and we can see here 18,000 records on a chart summarized. That is pretty good. Let's go back to our database, and we can see that this got imported. There was actually 75,000 records. So you can see here, I have actually added the number of records I have in my file. So you can see that I'm planning very ambitiously over here. So this file was 75,000 records. Let's go back to Softr, and at the bottom it shows only 58, but this is still the data being processed over here. So you can see now it got updated. So it's showing now 75,000 records. That is not bad. You can see that wherever I move, this is instantly loading. So this is pretty fast. Like, I'm sure you have experienced Airtable hanging for minutes on end trying to load the data. You can see that this is pretty much instantly loading wherever I move the database. So this is already 75,000. So here we have 18, here we have 75,000. So we are already at 100, ladies and gentlemen. So this is pretty impressive. Let's upload 200. Let's see what it is. So the data is being imported, and you can see that I have dropped the file over here, which is 20 megabytes. Some systems don't take files bigger than 5 or bigger than 15. So the fact that Softr didn't crash, this is already pretty good. Looks like the file got successfully imported. So took about 4 minutes, and this was about 200,000 records. So you can see we have already 75 over here. And here it shows us about 103,000 records. But my guess is that this is still processing and counting all the records, right? So you can see that it got increased to 107. We are at about 109. So this is actually still indexing. So it looks like it got successfully uploaded, 111. So right now we have 200 over here, 75,000 over here, 18, 12, 20. So this is about 100,000. So we are already at 300,000 records. That is pretty impressive. So with no problem, we have loaded 300,000 records. And you can see that this is indexing the records, and we got to about 160,000. All right. So now let's do the ultimate test. Let's see what will happen if we are even able to drop a file that contains 950,000 records. The file that I have just added, you can see that this file over here, this is 90 megabytes. So I'm uploading to Softr 90 megabytes of data. I hope the team at Softr will regret providing us access to their software in beta. In the meantime, let's see if we can do a chart based on 200,000 records. As I was generating the mock files, I needed to add more social media just to be able to duplicate the records and have more of them. So I have added Reddit, MySpace, and you are looking right now at 200K of records. So that's why some of the view numbers are getting ridiculous over here. So that's why the numbers are so super high. So I'm positively impressed that Softr is handling huge amounts of data on the charts without too much trouble. As for importing, I have no idea whether this is going to work. That is close to 1 million records in a single table. So let's see. Let's see what Softr does. That took about 7-8 minutes, but I have just loaded close to 1 million rows into Softr. Like, this is still indexing. You can see I'll go back to the column that contains 200 plus. Now you can see 216,000 records. I have literally loaded 1 million records into Softr. So this is really impressive. I think altogether we have about 1.5 million. So this seems to be doing really, really well with high volume data. And the ingestion side, so I was really surprised to see files of that size, of 18 megabyte file, to be uploaded into a database. This is pretty. 1.5 million records in total. And you can see, like, it still seems to be working. And I was able to do charts on it, I would say. Pretty good execution. I am recording this next day, and I just wanted to really check whether this 950,000 records were here. Yes, they're all here. One thing that I noticed that is missing is that basically for the single select, we are missing some of the data at the bottom. And the reason for that is that when we import new data over here, so you can see when I drop a new file, it basically does a sample on 1,000 records. So it takes the first 1,000 records for a variability. So you can see here that in the first 1,000, it's seen Instagram and Facebook, and here it saw only one title. So based on that, when it's adding additional records, it was not matching with those specific fields. So you can see that here we have two. Here we have only one. So that's something probably that should be fixed during the import, or Softr should add ability here to change the data import type to a single select, which I'm guessing will come along at some stage. It did work, but it missed some of the data here. So obviously it's a problem at this stage, but in principle, it does hold 950,000 records plus another 400,000 or 500,000 across the other tables. Let's do now a short summary. How does this compare to Airtable? I said a lot of positive things and I'm pretty impressed with what I have seen, but let's start with why not. Obviously, it's not as polished as Airtable. Airtable has been around for 10 years, so you can imagine that they definitely spend much more development time. It's a difficult interface to replicate, but I would say Softr done a pretty good job. Another element is we don't know much at this stage about APIs. The strong side of Airtable is ability to get the data in and out, and they have fantastic, very easy API. So we don't know how and whether there will be an API to access Softr databases. Another element, there is a massive ecosystem that has been built out around Airtable. Many other services allow you to plug in Airtable fairly easily and sync data from those systems to Airtable. Another element that is missing as of now is automation. So you don't have automations, which I'm sure many of you have been using. Why it could potentially be an alternative to Airtable for some use cases, there's a huge benefit of having the database integrated with the front end. So there's no issue with syncing, all the data is already there. Looking at the pricing model, because there is no per seat license, it could be cheaper for a bigger team to use Softr and Softr databases only, because you might be then paying maybe even at the higher tier, depending how the database will get priced, maybe 130, 170, and so on. In Airtable, on a business plan with 10 people, you're at $450 per month. There are cases when Softr could be cheaper. And another element is that, obviously, as we can see, it can handle massive amount of data. Like, it is very useful in some use cases, not for everyone, but in some use cases, this would be a super strong selling point. As you can see, there are some use cases where Softr will be a great alternative to Airtable that could be cheaper, that could be use cases with bigger amounts of data, and so on. There will be some use cases when you might be happier with your existing setup. So either way, I think this is a fantastic development. I think this really opens a lot of use cases for Softr. And yeah, interesting to know what you guys think and if this could be useful for your projects. And let us know what you think in the comments below. And as always, thank you for watching and good luck automating your business.